Dawn breaks over the grasslands of central Brazil. A faint mist clings to the ground, and the air still carries the coolness of night. The tall grass sways gently in the breeze, disturbed only by the low, haunting call that drifts across the savanna. Not quite a scream, not quite a song, but something in between. Through the pale morning light, a tall, slender shape moves deliberately, pausing, listening, then striking with sudden precision. In one swift motion, it grabs a snake, carries it to a stone, and strikes again and again until the prey lies still. This is the Seriema, a bird with a distinctly prehistoric air. Elusive, loud, and strangely charismatic, it is the last living hint of a lineage that once gave rise to giants, the towering terror birds that dominated South America for millions of years. If you'd like to learn more, check out the document in the description with research papers and image credits. To understand the Seriema, we need to look back at its evolutionary history. Despite their long legs and predatory habits, Seriemas aren't closely related to hawks or eagles. They do resemble the secretary bird of Africa, but this similarity is deceptive, a product of convergent evolution, where unrelated species evolve similar adaptations in response to similar habitats. Seriemas are more closely related to falcons, yet even that connection is distant. Both belong to the clade Australaves, but falcons are closer to the other major lineages in that group, the parrots and songbirds, than they are to Seriemas. Seriemas themselves form the order Cariamiformes, and they are the only living members. Their extinct relatives, however, were far more diverse, and some were truly spectacular. The most famous are the terror birds in the family Forestraceae. Flightless predators that could reach up to 3 meters tall, they had massive, hooked beaks built for seizing and dispatching prey. They were swift, relentless hunters, stalking small mammals, reptiles, and other birds across South America's open plains and woodlands. Terror birds were apex predators in South America from at least 43 million years ago to as recently as 100,000 years ago, dominating ecosystems long after the non-avian dinosaurs vanished. The Cariamiformes were not limited to South America, and not all of them were predators. Strigogyps from France and Germany was a flightless bird that may have been herbivorous or omnivorous, while Ideornithidae, also from Europe, resembled small early Seriemas. These extinct relatives hint at a lineage that was once far more widespread and ecologically diverse than it is today. Modern Seriemas are the last surviving members of this remarkable family. Slender, cautious birds carrying a legacy that includes both small, agile species and towering hunters. The living Seriemas belong to the family Cariamidae, and today that family contains just 2 species, each in its own genus. The red-legged Seriema, Cariama cristata, ranges widely across central and eastern Brazil, spilling into Bolivia, Paraguay, Uruguay, and northern Argentina. The black-legged Seriema, Chunga burmeisteri, is slightly smaller and more reclusive. Its range overlaps with its cousins, especially in the southwest, covering parts of Bolivia, Paraguay, and Argentina. Both species share a remarkably similar body plan and ecology. So from here, we'll look at Seriemas as a group, noting differences where they're significant. Seriemas are built for life on the ground. They have long, sturdy legs which lift their bodies high above the grass, letting them cover ground steadily and efficiently. They're not sprinters, but can reach speeds up to 25 kilometers per hour, relying on endurance more than bursts of speed. Their bodies are lean and lightly built, with long tails acting as counterbalances during sudden changes in direction. Their wings are short by comparison. Seriemas can fly, but only for brief distances. Most of the time they choose to run instead, mostly taking to the air to reach roosts or escape immediate danger. When flight is necessary, Seriemas launch with a sudden burst, their short, rounded wings providing enough lift to reach low trees or dense shrubs. These brief flights are typically a last resort, but they allow the bird to avoid immediate threats or gain a vantage point over the surrounding grasslands. Their heads are equally distinctive. A striking feature of both species is the crest of feathers on the head. They can raise or lower it at will, using it during courtship, territorial displays, or when alarmed. Alongside their piercing calls, the crest serves as an important visual signal, helping Seriemas communicate with neighbours and rivals across the open grasslands. Below the crest sits a strong, slightly hooked bill and a set of powerful neck muscles, all tuned for striking and handling small prey with precision. Their eyes are forward-facing enough to judge distances well, and their vision is sharp, essential features for spotting movement in tall grass. This is aided by their height, giving them a vantage point to spot concealed prey. Adding to their expressive appearance are eyelashes. These are not hairs like mammalian lashes, but are instead modified feathers that look and function similarly, a rarity among birds. In Seriemas, they likely help protect their eyes from dust and filter bright sunlight. All of these traits, long legs, balanced bodies, expressive crests, sharp vision, and even those tiny eyelashes, all come together to define the modern Seriema before we even get to how they behave. Seriemas are mostly terrestrial, moving with a slow, deliberate gait that can suddenly turn into a quick run when needed. They spend most of the day on the ground, scanning the grass and low shrubs for prey. Insects, small reptiles, amphibians, and occasionally small mammals make up the bulk of their diet, though they will also eat fruit, tree gum, human crops like corn, and the eggs and chicks of other birds when they can. One of their most distinctive behaviours is how they handle prey. Small animals are not simply swallowed whole. Instead, a Seriema will carry its catch to a hard surface, such as a stone, and strike it repeatedly until it is incapacitated. This is part of the reason why its neck is so muscular. It helps it withstand the impact of smashing its prey into a rock. This technique is precise and efficient, showing a combination of patience, strength, and coordination. They also possess a striking physical feature, a long, curved claw on each foot, reminiscent of the sickle-shaped claws made famous by dromaeosaurids like Velociraptor and Deinonychus. This similarity isn't superficial. Paleontologists are studying Seriemas as living examples to help infer how those dinosaurs might have used their distinctive claws. There are reports, mostly from captive individuals, of Seriemas using this curved claw to pin larger prey and tearing off manageable pieces with their beak and other claws, a strategy that may be useful when the prey is too large to bludgeon on a rock. However, these observations are scattered and not well documented in the wild, so it remains unclear how common or significant this behaviour is in its natural environment. Seriemas are territorial birds, typically defending an area of around 20 hectares. A small, urban population of red-legged Seriemas has been recorded holding much larger territories, up to 80 hectares, likely because resources are patchy in urban environments. Research on territoriality is still limited and almost entirely focused on the red-legged Seriema. The black-legged Seriema is assumed to behave similarly, but until more field studies are done, its social ecology remains less certain. A territory is usually held by a breeding pair, sometimes accompanied by their latest offspring. Defending that space begins not with violence, but with sound. Seriemas produce one of the loudest, most recognizable calls in South America, a far-carrying, yelping scream that can echo for kilometers. As you can hear, this cry is highly distinctive, advertising their territory to neighbors and warning intruders to stay away. Beyond marking territory, Seriema's calls can also vary depending on the context. They may use short, sharper yelps when alarmed by predators, or softer, drawn-out calls when interacting with their mate. Observers have also noted duet-like exchanges between mates, which may help strengthen bonds and coordinate movements across the grasslands. They also patrol the boundaries of their territory, especially at dawn. As they walk, they may pause to call from elevated perches, a termite mound, a rock, a fallen log, anything that lets their voice project even further across the grasslands. Direct fights are uncommon, but they do happen. When they escalate, the classic display is a leap toward the rival, striking out with long legs and a two-footed kick, while flapping their wings for balance. A flurry of motion, that usually resolves the dispute before either bird is seriously hurt. They are most active in the early morning and late afternoon, resting during the hottest hours of the day. When they're not patrolling or hunting, Seriemas often take time to relax in the open grasslands. They enjoy sunbathing, sometimes resting on their sides with wings slightly spread, a behaviour that may help regulate body temperature or simply provide a moment of comfort in the sun. These quiet pauses not only help to regulate body temperature, but also offer moments of rest and vigilance, allowing Seriemas to observe their surroundings without moving. This rhythm, alternating hunting, patrolling, and resting, defines the daily life of these open country specialists. There are many more behaviours about these birds that we have only ever heard hints of, and possibly more that we are completely unaware of. For example, some anecdotal accounts suggest Seriemas may follow grazing animals, livestock or wild herbivores, much like cattle egrets do, to catch insects or other small animals disturbed by their movement. However, no detailed field study has confirmed how commonly or how successfully Seriemas use this tactic. Seriemas form long-term pair bonds, and breeding usually begins with a burst of calling at dawn. After a short courtship, the pair builds a nest several meters off the ground, often in the fork of a small tree or the top of a dense shrub. The structure itself is surprisingly simple, a loose platform of sticks lined with grass and leaves, with very little camouflage. The female typically lays two eggs, which both parents help incubate. Once the chicks hatch, they grow quickly, covered in dense down, and already able to clamber around the branches near the nest. By a couple of weeks old, they'll often leave the nest entirely, following the parents on foot as a small family group. One of the most important parts of their development is learning how to handle prey. The famous prey-smashing behaviour isn't purely instinctive. It has to be practiced. Adults will bring food to their young and demonstrate the technique, dropping or striking the prey against the ground, while the chicks watch and attempt smaller, clumsier versions of the same movement. Over time, those movements become more precise, and by the time they fledge, the young birds can dispatch their own prey with the sharp, decisive efficiency of an adult. While juveniles learn to hunt, they remain vulnerable to predators such as raptors, foxes, and small mammals. Parents stay close, using alarm calls and wing displays to warn and guide their young, ensuring that fledging occurs safely and that the chicks acquire essential survival skills. Juveniles may remain with their parents for several months before dispersing, after which they settle into their own territories, and the cycle begins again. In rural South America, Seriemas have long shared space with people. In rural parts of their range, they wander across ranchland and small farms, much as they do the natural savannas and shrublands around them. And in many communities, they're more than just familiar neighbours, they've become part of the local culture. Historically, Seriemas were sometimes kept as working animals, valued for their willingness to attack snakes. Farmers would raise a tame bird around the house or yard, where it patrolled for small reptiles and alarm called at anything suspicious. Whether they were truly effective snake controllers is hard to say, but the practice left a lasting impression. Even today, older rural stories often portray the Seriema as a guardian bird, brave and dependable. Seriemas were not just kept to dispatch snakes, but as remarkably effective sentinel birds. Their piercing territorial calls carry over long distances, and a Seriema will readily sound off when a stranger, predator, or unfamiliar animal approaches. Perched on fence posts or patrolling open yards, they serve as vigilant, semi-tame lookouts, a practical low-maintenance alarm system in the days before electric fencing and camera traps. Their loud, far-carrying call also features in regional folklore. In some rural communities, a particularly loud call is said to herald approaching storms, while a Seriema spotted sunbathing at dawn is thought to bring good fortune. These birds are woven into the soundscape and stories of the countryside, blending natural behaviour with local culture and belief. Today, Seriemas adapt readily to agricultural landscapes and tolerate human presence fairly well. They're a common sight on ranches, fence lines, roadside verges, and fallow fields, living at an intersection between wild grasslands and working farmlands. Today, both Seriemas species remain relatively widespread across their ranges. The red-legged Seriema in particular is still common in many areas. The black-legged Seriema has a smaller distribution and is less frequently encountered, but is not currently considered threatened. Their long-term outlook, however, is closely tied to the fate of South America's open habitats. Conversion of native grasslands and cerrado into cropland and pasture is the most significant pressure, steadily fragmenting the landscapes these birds rely on. Local persecution also occurs, sometimes out of concern for poultry, sometimes simply because Seriemas are conspicuous, though this is far less of a threat than habitat loss. Although Seriemas are adaptable, even tolerating lightly modified farmland, they ultimately depend on large open areas with scattered cover. Protecting these ecosystems benefits far more than just the Seriemas themselves. South American grasslands and savannas are biodiversity hotspots, home to giant anteaters, maned wolves, pampas deer, and a suite of specialized birds and reptiles. Conserving them means preserving an entire community of species that have evolved alongside fire, open horizons, and wide-roaming predators. Perhaps the most overlooked threat facing Seriemas isn't a single pressure, but a simple lack of information. For such distinctive, charismatic birds, surprisingly little research has been done, and almost all of it focuses on the red-legged Seriema. Studies on the black-legged Seriema are rare, often limited to brief ecological notes or incidental records. We still lack reliable population estimates for either species, and many aspects of their behaviour, movement ecology, and breeding biology remain poorly understood. This isn't because Seriemas are exceptionally rare. It's because open country birds in South America often receive far less scientific attention than forest species. As a result, early signs of decline, shifts in distribution, or changes in breeding success may go unnoticed until they're much harder to reverse. Filling in these knowledge gaps matters. The more we know about how Seriemas use their habitat, how large their home ranges really are, and how they respond to farming and fragmentation, the better equipped we'll be to conserve not just the birds themselves, but the grassland ecosystems they represent. Seriemas are living echoes of an ancient lineage, slender, cautious birds that carry the legacy of towering terror birds through the open grasslands of South America. They hunt with patience and precision, their long legs and powerful necks honed for striking prey, their piercing calls echoing across savannas and ranchlands alike. Yet, for all their visibility and distinctive charm, so much about them remains a mystery. We still have much to learn about their numbers, their movements, and the subtle rhythm of their lives. In that uncertainty lies both a challenge and a wonder. These birds remind us that even the most unusual, seemingly familiar creatures can keep secrets, quietly shaping the ecosystems they inhabit. Protecting Seriemas isn't just about two species of bird. It's about preserving the open habitats, the grasslands and savannas, that support a web of life uniquely adapted to the rhythm of fire, wind, and wide horizons. It's about understanding and cherishing the wildness that still survives alongside human presence, and remembering that there are always stories waiting to be discovered in the world around us. I hope you enjoyed this journey into the world of Seriemas. If this video sparked your curiosity, don't let it stop here. Share it, talk about it, and keep learning. There's still so much to discover about the world's rare and remarkable species. And the more we understand, the better our chances of protecting them. Thanks for watching.